Welcome all the sports fans to another edition of Around the Rim. I am your host, the Dudster, Nesta Dudley. The journey to March Madness continues this week, and who we have up here, guest Jamal Baskin of the first place, 12-1, 11-1. They only got one loss, the 12-1 Bullets. Jamal, welcome to Around the Rim, buddy. Jamal, we're going to take really good care of you. We know you just moved to the area a couple of seasons ago. Yeah. And from what I understand, you don't watch Around the Rim, but we're not going to hold that against you. Jamal, your Bullets, first place. Let me read down this roster. Yourself, Jamal Baskin, Jonathan Diaz, Michael Bonaparte, Jimmy Dean, Vladimir Samuel, Victor Tran, Elins Joseph, Justin Gillis, Jeremy McCormick, Frank Cipriano. Jamal, this is your first year in the MNBL. The Bullets, former champions, they won two seasons ago, 20-4. They tried to retain their title last year. They lost in a big dance to the Lakers, the one team, the only team that you've had a loss to. But your Bullets, Jamal, are sitting in first place. Tell me about it, buddy.
It feels good right now, you know, to carry a team to first place and all. And, you know, being the point guard that I am, do my thing in the league, show them how I do from Boston.
There you go. There you go.
Representing.
And I got to tell you, doing the thing that you do, showing what you do, repping from Boston, folks had no idea how much of an impact player you were going to be this season. A virtual unknown commodity. Glenn Higgins said he had an idea, but you ask Glenn Higgins has the answers to it all. But impact player, how is it in this Bullets organization, when you got the likes of, you got returners, you got three-year returners of Jimmy Dean, you got Michael Bonaparte, Justin Gillis, these are three-year vets, and you just mold right in there, you just fit like a hand in a glove.
That's what I do. I like to, you know, get together with my team, you know, no matter if it's veterans or freshmen or whatever. I just like to, you know, cooperate with everybody, and I really think we're going to do this good until, you know, the end of the season.
You mean you were doubting your own skills?
No, I was doubting my own
skills. Oh, you weren't doubting? Oh, okay.
No. I'm just saying, you know, as the veterans there, I thought they was going to, you know, take the lead of the team, you know, but, you know, me stepping up and they needed a point guard, I just did what I had to do.
I got to tell you, I remember you at tryouts, Jamal, and I just remember you just lightning quick from one end of the floor to the other. You just broke away from the pack and you were dribbling and everyone else was running. You know, you could kick it, brother. Bullets, as we said, first place. Hawks right behind you in second place, Jamal. Record 10-3. And this weekend, you have the Hawks.
Well, it's going to be a hard game, you know, with Jamie Guest as point guard. And, you know, the shooting guards is shooting real good. But I think we have what it takes to beat them, you know, with Jimmy Dean down low. And we got our shooters, Bonaparte and Justin Gillis when he comes in. And we get to take over.
Now, what's the philosophy in the Bullets camp when it comes to practicing? Now, I certainly do not expect you to give away any team secrets. But what's the general philosophy in the practice? I mean, Steve Wright has always been up here. He's been up here now for 14 years on this show. We've always had a ton of Steve Wright coming here a lot of times. And usually when we have slots for the players, there's always been a Bullets player. More often than not, it seems like the Bullets are in first place or in Madness contention. But what is it like playing in this type of a league? You know, because this is a rec league, and you are a high talent in this league.
Yep. In practices, he always talks about defense. And I like playing defense, you know, get steals and passing the ball and the fast breaks, you know. Fast breaks my specialty, as you know.
Oh, yeah, you know, we've seen it.
It's just defense and practice makes perfect. And you practice a lot, you have nothing to worry about when you get in the game.
Bullets, Jamal, on an 11-game win streak. Do you think that would happen? I mean, with this team, I mean, Steve Wright always downplays his team. He always says that his team can be better. He's never satisfied with the defense. But bottom line, Jamal, 11-game win streak, man, that's like, you know, that's all right.
It is. It really is. Because, to be honest, I really think we're going to go 11 games straight. But, you know, we pulled through in some hard games, you know, free throws and down low and a lot. Pulled through, won a real close games.
I mean, you know, there's been... Go ahead, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
No, it's fine.
You know, there's been a few teams, even though the Bullets only have one loss, there has been a few teams that have given the Bullets a run. I mean, you know, the Bullets 11-game win streak, 12-1. But it's with the exception of one team, the Sixers. It seems like every time the Bullets play the Sixers, the Bullets pretty much destroy the Sixers. But with the exception of that, there are some hot teams in the league. Sonics, for instance, that the Sonics have had a long history of beating the Bullets. They haven't beaten the Bullets this year. Only one team has done that. And no one even knows how that happens, basically. Because the Bullets, tough, tough squad. And I did predict the Bullets to go to the big dance. Bradwith Benton predicted the Bullets to win the whole damn thing. And I'm sure you like that prediction.
Yeah.
But, you know, tell me about your teammates. We talked about, well, we haven't really talked about the teammates in depth. You have Jimmy Dean, who is a front runner right now for league MVP. But I would certainly say that you're in that category of league MVP. You're averaging, by my unofficial stats, you're averaging close to 19 points. These are unofficial stats. Bradwith Benton could have you like a point or two higher. But you're certainly in the top five as far as league MVP. But what is it like playing with someone like Jimmy Dean?
It's fun, you know. It's like Shaq and Kobe.
Yeah.
You know, with him down low, if nothing happens around the perimeter, bust down low, and he does what he does down low. And it's fun working with him. And there's just other players like Justin Gillis. He shoots, and he's Mr. Clutch. And, you know, when the time comes, he drives or he shoots it, and it usually goes in. And everybody else on the play, they play around, you know, pretty good. And then next thing you know, we win.
Jamal, you heard the music. What that segment is that you are officially caught up in the MNBL web. What that segment is, just to remind folks, is that in the MNBL web, I can ask my guests a series of questions for up to 3 minutes, and these questions may or may not have to do with the MNBL. Jamal, you watch the NBA?
Yes.
Is there one person that you try to patent your game after?
Yes.
Who was that person?
Paul Pierce.
Paul Pierce.
Yes.
And I thought you probably said someone like Iverson or something like that.
No.
Paul Pierce. So you're a Celtic fan?
I wouldn't say
no,
Celtic.
You wouldn't say
that. I'm not a Celtic fan. Well, from Boston, I do have to remember Celtics, but I'm really not the Celtics. Just the reason I picked Paul Pierce, because he's like an all-around player, you know.
Mm-hmm.
He does everything mostly for the team. You know, he shoots it. He makes the big plays when he has to make them, you know. The few games last night, he did pretty good. And that's why, you know, I like Paul Pierce better than any other mostly team on it.
What would be your team in the NBA?
I would have to say Phoenix Suns.
Phoenix.
Because they do like fast breaks, definitely.
Yeah, you're a fast break player.
Yes.
You might end up on the wrong team. There's a couple of teams that run the fast breaks. The Kings are one that are sitting in third place. I'm sure that, is it true to the rumors that you want to get traded to the Kings?
No. Okay. I don't know about that. You know. There are some rumors, but no. I'm a Bullet for life.
NBA Finals, who do you think it'll be? What two teams?
I would have to say Detroit and the Suns.
Okay. Jamal Baskin, yes. You are officially out of the web. See, we took care of you. That was it. You know, that web was so good. Get him out of the web. Could be back on camera two. Camera three, that's cool. Back in the studios of Malden Access, I'm your host, Dustin Nesta Dudley, along with Jamal Baskin, representing the Bullets. Jamal, we talked about Jimmy Dean. We talked a little bit about Gillis. You have Michael Bonaponte, who's also a three-year senior. And, you know, we said at the beginning of the show that you just blended into that Bullet team. You were basically one of the steals of the draft, if not the biggest steal in the draft, a virtual unknown to most coaches.
Yeah, no, I really didn't think that I was going to play for the Bullets, you know, because I was, you know, sitting on my couch because – I didn't have everything to play for the teams, you know. And I was just sitting on the couch, and I get a phone call from my friend Jonathan Diaz, who also played for the Bullets.
Mm-hmm.
And he told me, he's like, guess what team you are? I'm like, what team? He's like, the Bullets. It's like, how did that happen? He's like, I don't know. Coach called me and told you to get in touch with you. I was like, okay. I called the coach, told me he was on the Bullets. Next thing, I came to the first practice, introduced myself to the team. And we're good.
And introduce yourself to the league and to the tune of the Bullets only having one loss. What do you think of your head coach, Steve Wright?
I think he's one of the best coaches. Tops down, best coach.
Now, you could tell the truth because he lives up in Drake and he can't get this show.
he's a good coach.
Yeah, yeah.
Mostly defense because I like defense, so that's what me and him have in common a lot. And he loves it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man.
Jamal, right now, there is no clear-cut team that's in fourth place. Bullets clinch playoffs, first place. Hawks are in second place. Kings are in third place. All three teams clinched. Right now, the Sonics are the front runners to get in that fourth place. If the Sonics lose in some grace of higher power, then there could be a one-game playoff between the Sonics and the Lakers. But for all intents and purposes, the Lakers are out of it. So, Jamal, how it works in this league is that the madness will be the first game. It will be the Team 1 versus Team 4. And Team 4, most likely than not, will be the Sonics. The Sonics at one point was on a 5-game win streak with J.P. Lewis, Nick Kelly, Tom Redford, Danny Lou, Sean Chase, Jeff Legentes, Jeff Williams, Charlie Ferguson, Jake Halloran. What will you need to do, in your opinion, to keep that team in check? They're three big players or four big players, Jake Halloran, Charlie Ferguson, J.P. Lewis, and Nick Kelly. What would the Bullets need to do to avoid an upset? Because if the Sonics did beat the Bullets in the madness, that would be an upset.
I would have to say number one, defense. Because their point guard does like to drive in through the middle a lot. And, you know, if we tighten in the defense, then we can stop him. And the baseline, J.P. Kelly loves the baseline. If we stop that, which is probably James Dean or Bonaparte or Victor Chern, if we stop that, then that's good too. And the fast breaks, got to love fast breaks. That's where we get most of our points, off steals and the fast breaks.
And now the second round, the second game of the madness would be the Kings up against the Hawks. And the Hawks roster, Ray Charles, Jonathan Monroe, Rubens Legentes, Kevin Liu, Jamie Guest, Dave Israel, Vicente Pio, Sam Pierre, William Liu, Rolf Prezum, John Generacio, Kings, Staminsky Cadet, Roger Hickey, Leslie Philippe, Brian Horton, Danny Suter, Richie Rogers, Demir Safia, Sean McFeely, Gene Bastien, Brett Plowman, Hawks, Kings. In your opinion, Jamal, pick one. Which team would win that game?
I don't want to, you know, people get mad at me.
It's certainly your opinion. We are all allowed our opinions. So, in your opinion, what team could win that game?
I'll have to go with the Hawks.
And why would you go with the Hawks? Again, this is Jamal's opinion.
My opinion.
It's his opinion.
My opinion.
If you all want to come up here and express your opinion, you certainly can be a guest on Around the Rim. But your opinion, why would it be the Hawks?
Because they have more talent. And they have a good point guard, a very good point guard. Before I came in, he was known as the best point guard of the league. And
he's still known as the best point guard in the league.
He is. I don't want to take his spot. You know? I don't want to take that. You know, he can keep that title. I just want to bring my team to the championship.
So the big dance would be the Bullets and the Hawks. That's certainly something that I didn't picture. That's something that Brad Withbenton didn't picture. But we both had the Bullets in there. So, big dance. I'm not going to ask you who would win out of the Bullets and the Hawks, because I'd be damn surprised if you said the Hawks. But what would you need to do to keep that same Hawk team in check? The Hawks only have three losses, and you're playing the Hawks this weekend, too, from that makeup snow game.
Yeah. I would have to say, I don't know why I keep saying it, but it is the defense. No matter what you do, it's always the defense.
It doesn't matter you keep on saying defense, because offense will win games, but defense will win championships.
Yep. That phrase goes for everything, football, basketball, whatever you play. Play defense, don't matter where the offense comes from, it's always the defense.
You play high school football?
Yeah.
What position?
Running back and safety.
Okay. Yeah. You like to run.
Yep.
And you're a fast runner.
That's why I get most of my speed.
Yeah, let me tell you. So, but we've been saying for 2-3 seasons now that the Hawks offense flows as Jamie Guest flows, but we hear that music. It's time to go into the Roland. So, Jamal, you really don't watch the show, so why don't you sit back and relax? We're going to go into the Roland. So, Waldo, go ref, go RA. When you're ready, throw it up. Let's kick it. Then we'll come back into the studios with Jamal Baskin. Last week, the week of March 14th, I don't hear the music, go ref, go. Lakers Pistons, and that was overtime. Pistons defeated the Lakers 63-59. Joe Armstrong led the Lakers with 21 points. Kevin Barry led all scores with 27 points. Next game, Sonics Bullets. Bullets beat the Sonics 58-36. Halloran, high man, put the Sonics with 15 points. Jimmy Dean led all scores with 31 points. Third game, Kings Celtics, an upset. The Celtics 12 points better than the Kings, 72-60. Danny Suter, high man with the Kings, 17 points. Bobby Skane led all scores with 25 points. Celtics, Bullets, Skane beyond the arc, where everything is three. Weiner, Toscane, Tresurtle, rocking the team work. Justin Gillis, coast to coast. He left Medford, Mass. He ended up in Medford, Oregon. Touchdown. Baskin to the rack. Sertle assisting Alan Tam. Dean steals it like Moses Guthrie. And patience on the inbound is a good thing. Vladimir Samuel, he just throws it off the glass. Weiner with the lefty groove after recess. Drew Weiner straight swerving. Justin Gillis, he's going to stroke all three of these. Jimmy Dean, he just bum rushes David Basari. O'Leary in the paint. Baskin with the long distance rebound. And Dean to Baskin on the giddy up. Bullets victorious over the Celtics. Score 69-59. Drew Weiner led the Celtics 24 points. Jimmy Dean led all scores with 27 points. The Bulls improved to 12-1. The Celtics dropped to 4-9. Next game, Hawks, Sixers. Jamie Guest setting the table for three. LaFosse in the Crayola. Sixers spreading the love all around. Sam Pierre cuts the paint. Emmanuel, he just shoots it in David Israel's eyes. LaFosse on the DL. And Jamie Guest, he strokes it deep, and I don't think it's reboundable. The next set, Jamie Guest just had himself a three-point party. Rolf Prezum with a little jumper. Legentis heaves it to Prezum. Vaughn finds LaFosse. And Ray Charles playing blind man's bluff. Hawks victorious over the Sixers by a score of 60-54. Kenny LaFosse led the Sixers with 18 points. Jamie Guest led all scores with 22 points. Why is that slate coming up? The third game.
Technical difficulties.
Third game, Kings, Lakers, Safia stroking all three of these. Berger tells Safia, get that wink bookie out of here. Berger tells Safia, I done told you once, son. Ward intercepts it and finds Armstrong. And Brenda Berger having a block party. He gets Rogers. Then he gets Philippe, victims. They are victims. 2-3. Suter to the rack, but he just becomes another victim. And Philippe is a repeat customer. And Brendan Berger, he's just going off, having himself a block party. Bastion denied by Berger, but Hickey with the hoop and the hum. Final frame. Safia beyond the arc, where everything is three. Armstrong through the back door. Rogers at the line, where everything is free. Ward strokes it deep, and I don't think it's reboundable. Ward, long three stroking. Brendan Berger with his first career three-pointer, but it was to no avail. Kings over the Lakers, 60-53. Jameer Safia had a career game, 19 points, high man for the Kings. Steve Ward led all scorers with 23 points. The Kings improve to 7-4. The Lakers drop to 7-7. And that's what happened at last week's games. So Waldo, if we are ready, let's kick it to the weekly Around the Rim Awards. Player of the Week, Joe Armstrong. Joe Armstrong had himself a career weekend. Career high, 21 points Friday, solid game Sunday. Joe Armstrong graduating Player of the Week. Coach of the week, Paul Conrad of the Pistons. His never-say-die attitude, getting his players up to compete in every game, and they did compete, and they are on a one-game win streak. Team of the week, got to be the Bullets. When you won 11 straight games, Bullets team of the week. Woo of the week goes to Demir Safier of the Kings. Career game, I believe that was his career high, 19 points. If it wasn't, it's pretty close to it. Maybe career high was 21 points. But in any case, Demir Safier, he was pulling those threes straight out of his bunkie. Demir Safier, this woo is for you. Woo! Now on to the official standings. Remember, I don't care who you talk to. Bullets, Hawks, Kings, clinch, they're in. Sonics, a matter of time, they're just going to be in. Lakers, Celtics, Pistons, Sixers. On the outside looking in, basically this sports fan, this sports reporter have to tell you that if something happens and the Sonics drop their next two games, they'll be 7-7. The Lakers are 7-7. It will be a one-game playoff. It will be next Tuesday at Malden High. But this reporter don't see it happening. Just give it to the Sonics. Now on to Go Refs Go's favorite category. Go Ref Go.
The dirtiest dozen of them all.
The dirty dozen. Ken LaFosse has tied the 14-game mark of 55 fouls.
We were talking about that last week.
He has tied it, and LaFosse has one game.
So he could break it.
One game left.
LaFosse, he can break it.
LaFosse's never going to break that record. Once again, this 14-game mark was set by Jimmy Neville, 1993, the Hawks. Serto, Langston, Berger, Luis, McCown, Halloran, Rogers, Vilsaint, Tran, Bastien, Charles, those.
And what's Charles's first name?
Rashawn, but we call him Ray Charles.
I can see why he would be on the Dirty Dozen.
Because he can't see a damn thing. Next week's games. Next Saturday, first game, Pistons, Sixers, second game, Sonics, Kings. That second game is going to be the Battle of the Brothers, and that's actually the end of the regular season. Sunday would have been a free day, but Sunday is going to be the makeup days from the snow date. So Sunday's game, first game, Bullets Hawks, second game, Celtics Sonics, third game, Pistons Kings. All of the games are snow makeups. That's what's happened this past weekend. So now, March, which is International Month of Women, Women History Month, the tradition is going to continue, and we're going to spotlight a historical woman. Agnes Nestor, 1880 to 1948, glove maker and union activist. She helped form the Women's International Glove Workers Union and served as its president and as other officers. From 1904 until her death in 1948, she also served as president of the Chicago Women's Trade Union League. Other issues she was involved with included an 8-hour workday, child labor, minimum wage, and woman suffrage. That is your woman highlight of the moment, Agnes Nestor. Around the Rim is live every Thursday, 7:30 to 3. Except for next week. Thank you, Waldo. That's why Waldo has been with me for all 14 seasons. Next week's Around the Rim is the 1-hour All Madness special. Starts at 7. It's going to end at 8. We know Steve Wright's going to be up here. We know Bonaco Stroud's going to be up here. I'm assuming Glenn Higgins is going to be up here. We just don't know. It just hasn't been confirmed until this weekend that Chuck Rogers or Gary Rogers or Troy Dinkins will be up here in the
Either one
spot.
Of them would be one good guest.
Either one of them. Around the Rim repeats every Friday night, 10 in the p.m. on channels 3 and channels 15. And Around the Rim repeats every Saturday morning, 7 in the a.m. on channel 3. When to watch them? You can watch the games of the MNBL every Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday from 3 p.m. on channels 3 and 15. Channel 3 is the public channel. Channel 15 is the educational channel. The GOT Tweet, the game of the week, is every Friday night.
The GOT W.
The GOT W. Go to. Could be a number of them. Every Friday night, 10:30 in the p.m., channels 3 and 15, the game of the week this past week, Celtics, Hawks, from February 26th of this year. Where to read them? Every Friday night in the Malden Evening News. And if you're too cheap to spend the 75 cents, the official website of the MNBL is mnbl19.tripod.com. Back in the studios here of Around the Rim, Waldo, how much time we got left? I'm talking to you, Waldo. How much time we got left?
3 minutes.
We got 3 minutes. Jamal, this could be a bullet year. The Bullet could have 2 championships in 3 years. That has rarely been done in the MNBL. Your first time in this league, you could go home. You're pretty much going to go home with the trophies. But in this league, Jamal, it's all about the jackets. And those are some nice jackets. They keep you warm. Keep you warm in the winter.
Yeah, I seen them. And leather ones, real warm.
You got to get that jacket.
I want it. The whole team want it. Coaches want it.
We were talking before all that happened that the offense for the Hawks flow as Jamie Guest flow. And what would you need to do to contain Jamie Guest? Because if it goes to a man-to-man matchup, I'm assuming you would be the one that would pick up Jamie.
I will. It'll probably be either not man-to-man, it'll be boxing one, me on Jamie Guest. And just got
and Jamal, he's
the ball.
So smart. He is so smart.
Smart. Oh, man. I heard that on his MCAS. He had 1 point from a perfect score.
Damn.
1 point from a perfect score. That's all, oh, man.
Yeah.
That's crazy. But just deny him the ball. Don't give him the ball as much as you can. Don't give him the ball.
Jamal, thanks for coming here as a guest on Around the Rim. It was a pleasure to have you.
Pleasure to be here.
Good luck to you and your Bullets. Hopefully we'll see you in the big dance, and maybe we'll see you up here in a couple of weeks as the Bullets would be the 2006 champions, MNBL champions.
Yep.
Until next time, I just want to say buenas noches, huchas, cuchas. I came in peace. I leave with love. This is for the red, the black, and the green, and I'll be seeing you at the games.
Earl the Pearl and Will, Big O, and Jerry West.